first of all, you can use your Snap and Read, and you can have this being read to you, so you can listen to all of that information.
I absolutely love using Snap and Read because a lot of information that you find online is written at a higher lexile. And so these students are trying to find information about their person that they're researching, and they can't read half the words on there. It doesn't matter if they have an IEP or not. You know, even if they have a higher lexile, there are words and stuff that they've never been exposed to before. So the first thing I love about Snap and Read is we allowing the Snap and Read to read the text out loud to them so they can hear it, so they can hear the story of that person's life.
Sometimes we get into the bigger grades, like eighths sometimes I get into, and there's harder words, and she lets us use it for us to learn what those words are.
We have students will open up an outline tool in Snap and Read, and they will pull information over from the website. And what I love about that is a lot of kids have trouble copying down information, you know, on a board or on a computer down into a piece of paper, especially kids who are dyslexic or have reading decoding issues and that eye tracking problem. And so they'll lose their place or they'll get half of it written down, they're not sure. But to go through and then see on that outline that's right there next to the text, and they see date of birth and they look over like, oh, it's right there, they highlight it and boom, it's there.
Today we are going to be using Snap and Read to drag information into an outline so that we can write our biographies on our explorers.
They don't have that fear of like, oh, I'm copying it wrong. They don't have that extra step. They're just learning. Whenever we do any sort of writing in class, before they submit it to me or before they get it edited, they have to use their Snap and Read tool to listen to it back to them. And when we write and when we read things, we read what we think we wrote because you know what your thoughts were. And same thing with kids. They know what they were saying, but they don't catch all those mistakes. And they'll put the headphones on, they'll listen, and it helps so much with those simple edits. They know how much better it makes their writing.
I may have a word that doesn't sound like it should be there, and then I would take it out or replace it with another word.
It's pushing their lexiles even higher, and it's giving them exposure to vocabulary that I could not expose them to. You think of it, oh, it's gonna help bring kids up. You don't think that it can also help push kids even farther than where they're at right now.